Okay, we're in Kayenta. We're going to Page, Arizona. Less than 2 hours away. A load of plows. Right there.
We were actually
going to head down to Texas, but these loads came up and you kind of have to go where the loads take you, right? I mean, you can't just pick and choose. You got to go where they take you. So that's what we're doing. We're following the loads. Construction. Yeah. Always working on the roads. Loads truck stop. Travel shops, I'm sorry. Well, this was supposed to be about a 2-hour trip. Might turn into the 3-hour cruise. Some of you might get that. Not a very heavy load.
Get ready to turn right. Turn right. Turn left. You have arrived at your destination. Your route guidance is now finished.
Your route guidance system is now finished. And we are done with this load, folks. So we have coming out of Page. Yep.
Well, I'll be coming in with a truck.
Okay.
I'm going to bed.
No. Really?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. That's fine. That'll be all right.
I'll have to take clothes out.
Probably. Probably so. Yeah. All right. I think I'm through for tonight. And we're back. Another Salina, Utah.
Ready to roll.
That's what we're going to start with now. It's about a 5-hour run, and it's already 11:30 in the morning. I don't usually start this late, but we're going to today. Take that big old harvester right there. Not this one. That one right there, the big boy. We're gonna take that big one.
Time to get the job done.
Let me find a good angle for a picture here. Well, maybe we can. Well, okay, the cameras are locked up. There we go. Well, trying to find a good angle for it. We can get a good picture of it. We can't. Oop, that's underneath the truck. We don't want that one. I guess the best we can do is right there. We're up against the building, so trying to get a picture of the... That's what we'll be hauling, right there. Wish we could get a good side view. It's hard to do that, though. Okay, let's do this. Let's pull out and get away from the building. Maybe we can get a better viewpoint so we can see it. About 4 hours and 49 minutes. It'll be a little bit tough getting out of here. Let's see if we can get out of here. We can see down the road here. Maybe we can do something.
Turn left.
Bit of a long load here. We do have some fuel on board, so we have three viewpoints. We do have three viewpoints on this trip. I'm going to go ahead and mark them when we stop for this first one right around the corner here. Well, there are three of them going up to Salina, so we're going to get three viewpoints. I hope we can. Okay, I was kind of hoping his car would get out of our way.
Here we go.
But that didn't happen, so now we're going to have to back up a little bit so we can get around it.
Never mind. I'll find a new route.
Of course you will. One thing I'd like to see them do in the game is when they send you into a scale or something like that, that they don't say they're going to find a new route. They're going to know that you're going into the scale or whatever you're doing. I noticed when they send you into the scale to be weighed, you have to find a new route when you come out. And so I'm not sure why that is. They should know you're going into the scale. They sent you there, but apparently the game doesn't pick up on that. But that would be kind of cool. Little detail. Nothing major. Little detail. Hey, we're okay on fuel. We don't need fuel. Donuts would be good, but fuel? No, we're good. baking of scales. There was a notice there for a scale. And folks, we are in Utah. Coming down this hill.
Stay right, and then continue straight. Go straight.
It's one thing we don't do in this game. We don't do a lot of rest areas, the truck stops for the parking areas. And the reason being, because I have a developer app on here and I can advance the clock as I need it. So I don't have to find a parking area to sleep. So I never understood why that was an important part of the game, because you can basically you pull in an empty field or park at the shippers or sometimes or whatever, but I don't see a reason to have to go to a parking area to sleep, other than it adds a little challenge to the game if you use the fatigue
right,
indicator.
And then turn right.
Which I don't. If you use the fatigue indicator, it will put you at sleep time, which is a good thing and a bad thing. The good thing about that is, that it keeps you on track for the realism of the game. The bad thing about that is that if you're not near a sleep place, that clock will keep ticking and eventually your screen will go black and you can't drive. And then you're pretty well screwed. So, yeah. I don't have it on here because I don't go by regular hours. It just adds too much of a challenge to the game for me. I chase the lows, I don't chase the clock. I should, because it would make it more realistic, but Yeah, I don't.
Straight.
Damaged vehicle? What? What the heck? What are they talking about? Wait a minute. How's there a damaged vehicle? There's nobody even around me. What the heck? Alrighty. Well, we'll try to get a picture of that. Oh, there you go. Now we can. Where did the damaged vehicle one come from? Okay. Well, there's something interesting. We stopped at the scale and got a damaged vehicle. Well, alrighty then. I'm gonna have to look into that one because that was weird. That was just weird. Almost went by it. Almost drove by it. Wasn't paying attention here, folks. Wasn't paying attention. Was not paying attention. Almost missed it. Maybe it's a good thing I did that. I didn't block those other cars in. Ha.
stay right, and then turn right. Turn right. Stay left, and then turn left. Turn left. Get ready to turn right. Turn right.
I think I missed it. I have to go around again. Missed it. Whoops, maybe I didn't.
Okay, let's find a new route.
It's not here. Oh, there it is. There it is. I did miss it. I did miss it, folks. Now we'll go deliver this harvester.
Turn left.
Three of them done now for this trip, and that leaves three more in the state of Utah. Two in one direction and one in the opposite direction from where we're going right now. So, yeah, we have to make a decision here. What do we do? It is 8:50 p.m. So, yeah, a little later than I like to drive. It's all good. It's for a good cause, right? We're sightseeing. It's one thing the truck drivers tell me they can't do is they travel all those miles and they never have time to sightsee. They never have time to stop and see things that they want to see. So when they retire sometimes, they buy a motorhome and go see all the things that they missed when they were driving a truck. So, yeah, it's not a sightseeing trip like mine. Because on my game, I really don't care. I'm out for the sightseeing. Driving truck is a sideline, I guess, right? Get paid to go sightseeing. And for the most part, we're not late when we do that, so it's okay. Nobody's harmed, right? No harm, no foul. Watch the sunset a little bit. If you look at the GPS on the dash, we see the little checkered flag. We're almost there.
Stay right, and then exit right. Exit right. Get ready to turn left. Turn left. Stay left, and then turn left. Turn left.
Oh.
Stay right. Computing.
Recomputing, yet we're here. I don't understand that. I think the GPS is screwed up on this game. I do. A lot of times it tells you turn right and it's a left, and it tells you turn left and it's a right, and it tells you recomputing and you're on the right path. And yeah, I think the GPS needs some work. But anyhow, we are here. We're done. We're done for the night. It is late at night. I'm going to sleep in the game. And we will catch you on the next one. Don't know what we're going to do next. We may go to Moab. We may go to St. George. We don't know yet. We'll see what they got. And we'll see you on the next one. See you when we see ya. Bye.